Hello, welcome to Sculpt with Sid. My name is Sydney. I am a barre Pilates and yoga instructor in Toronto. Today's class is a full body barre class. We're gonna use our regular props, so light weights and a booty band. But if you do have one heavy dumbbell, so anything from like 10 to 15 to 20, we're gonna do some exercises with just one weight. But if you don't have that, we'll make it work. Okay, so let's get started. You're gonna start standing and we'll do a quick warm up. Step your feet wider than your hips. Take a big breath in, look up. Exhale, side bend to the right. Inhale, lift. Exhale, switch. One more each side, really stretching through side body and just starting to wake up through your breath. Inhale, lift. Exhale, side bend. And pause up through center. Heel toe your feet a little bit closer, so you're in a sumo position. You're gonna find a sumo squat, elbows row back, and then open up to a T at the top. Good. So just move nice and big here, whatever pace feels right with your body. Finding our sumo squats really just to start to wake up the legs. Good, and then move your arms with resistance. As if you're in water, you're gonna create that warm up for your shoulders, your chest as well. Good, right here, can you think about your heels really rooting into the floor? Like there's literal roots growing down into the floor. Push down to stand up. Take your bum back, really squeeze your glutes. Yes, good. And then can you find containment through your core right away? This is a full body class, but when we're focusing on, say, lower body or upper body, I still want your core to really be working. Keep it nice and activated. Good, three more here. Two. Awesome, one, hold at the top. Let's come to the top of your mat. So you're gonna keep your sumo, feet are pretty much mat width, hands are gonna come to heart. Sumo squat, slide your left foot in towards your right. Step your left foot back, find a lunge. Slide your left toes back in, and then find your squat again, switch sides, right toes slide in, right toes slide back. You've got it, just keep coming side to side, forward and back, through your lunges and your sumo squats. If you're feeling energetic today, you can definitely make this a little bit faster. Listen to your body though. Some days we step onto our mats to exercise, we think it's gonna be like, whew, best workout ever. And then we realize we're drained as hell. So if you're having a drained day, move slow, stay connected to your breath. If you've got that little bit of fire in you today, move faster, just make sure you're still in control. We're gonna do one more each side. Good. The next time you come into a lunge with your right foot forward, left foot back, hold. Just find that lunge. We're gonna lean forward. Straighten your back leg, arms come overhead. You're in an incline lunge here. We're gonna come into an upright lunge, arms sweep wide, bend your knee under your hip. Ooh, shoulders over hips. Good, lean forward, find an incline, sweep wide, come upright. So here I really want you to push into your front heel, squeeze your right bum, and notice the difference between an incline spine and then an upright spine. All right, no matter what, you've got a really long line from head to tailbone. But sometimes we're gonna hinge over that front hip. Sometimes we're gonna stack shoulders over hips. Two more. The next time you lean forward, hold. Hands come down, find a plank. Step your right foot back and just hold. Take a moment, find that really strong plank, palms pushed down. Spread the shoulder blades out, rib cage pulls up and in, belly button lifts. Squeeze your bum, squeeze your inner thighs. Good, we're gonna pedal out the knees. So just like you're doing a little dance with the knees. Find your breath. Good, last five, four, three, two, one. Left foot steps forward. Find your lunge on the other side. Back up to that incline, arms reach forward. Hold for a second, connect back to the core. Awesome, arms sweep wide, bend your back knee. Lean forward. Back knee bends, upright. Lean forward, back leg straightens. Good, so arms are making a nice big sweep. Movement to the sides, and then overhead. You should feel a little bit of work coming up into your shoulders as you reach overhead. But anytime in class, if when we reach overhead, you feel tension in your neck, don't do it, just reach lower. All right, so inhale, reach back. Exhale, reach forward. Getting used to linking your breath. Really good. This is our last little flow of our warm up. Last two, coming back to your plank. This time down onto your forearms. Last one. Lean forward, hold. Hands come down, footsteps back. Come down to your elbows, maybe your knees as well, or you can lift your toes. Or sorry, come onto your toes, lift your knees. Whatever you wanna do, just hold. All right, so this time we're not gonna move. I want you to find a place where you can stay nice and still, which is a little challenging at the end of a warm-up where we've kind of just moved continuously. See if you can slow the breath down. Yes, find that control in your plank. You are still there, don't mind me. Press your forearms down, feel the space between your shoulder blades widen, the space between your rib cage shorten, so really squeeze ribs in. Squeeze inner thighs, squeeze bum, lift the backs of the knees to the ceiling. You are holding just for 10 more seconds, and then we'll get into some combo work. Really good. Keep breathing, lengthen the crown of your head forward, heels back for 4, 3, 2, 1. Quick child's pose, bum comes back. Take a big inhale, exhale, roll up. Come all the way up to standing and bring your weights with you. So bring your set of dumbbells. So something a little bit lighter, anything from like 1s to 8s, I would say is like lighter, but whatever feels light in your body where you can do a little bit of a shoulder burn. Feet come under your hips, find a chair shape. So just stick your bum back, arms reach back. You're just gonna hammer curl the arms. Curl in, reach back, in and back. Awesome, nice and simple. We're gonna turn this into a combo series. That means your whole body's gonna be moving. But if you do wanna focus just on the upper body, you can definitely just do the arm movements that I show you. We've got that incline forward again. So again, thinking really strong core, flat back. Just about a 45 degree angle. Amazing, last 4. Then we'll add the legs. 3, 2, and 1. When you curl, you straighten the legs, lift, lower, send the arms back. Lift and lower, lift and lower. Good. Again, find that pace that works. My playlist, the music that you can hear in the background, is always a nice sort of cadence to go with the beat of the music when we're moving a little bit faster. And then to go to a 2 count in the music when we're moving a little bit slower. So this is where you can move with the beat. Good, keep squeezing your elbows in, lengthening through the shoulders. We have 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold at the bottom, let your arms release for a second. All right, hands are gonna start up at your shoulders. Everything's gonna straighten, you're gonna overhead press. So legs straighten, arms straighten, and then everything lowers. This one's gonna be a little slower. If you do wanna move to the 2 count, you can lift up for 2 and lower for 2. All right, so in warm up, when the arms went overhead, if that bothered your neck, you don't have to do an overhead press here. I want your elbows to start in your sides and then just bring your elbows to shoulder height. All right, that's a really nice option to still work your shoulders without having to come all the way overhead. All right, and then whatever option you're doing, no Elvis hip thrust. Try to keep hips right under shoulders. If anything, hips are a little bit further back. So ribs can really pull down and in. Stay supported through your core. And then yes, keep this slow, especially if you've got like under 5 pounds, super slow. 3 more like this. Use your exhale, inhale lower, exhale lift. Last one, we hold at the top, pause right here. Palms turn forward, shoulders down, your back, ribs down. We're gonna wide overhead press as you march. Like one of my favorite things to do, so if you've taken one of my classes before, you've definitely done this. It is a great way to do standing ab work. You have a lot of balance work to do here. As you march that knee, you're using your lower abs to lift, not your hip flexor. Yes, and then obviously the shoulders are burning. That's a given. Good. And if your balance is just not with you on any day when we march, do an alternating heel raise. And then same thing, if you don't want to overhead press, elbows come to shoulder height. Keep that 90 degree bend. Good, we have 4. Whatever option you're taking, stick with it till the end. 3, 2, and 1. Good, drop, release. Give your shoulders a roll. All right, lean forward, find that hinge again. Arms reach down, hug a big beach ball in front of you. We're gonna do a reverse fly. You're gonna open your arms wide and then squeeze them back in. Wide and then squeeze them back in. Okay, so try to move with control here back to that 2 count so this isn't too fast. Especially if you've got lightweights moving fast here. Nothing happens other than honestly probably your neck being bothered. So move slow. And then your balance challenge, if you want it, is to lift your heels. Woo, so everything lifts at the same time, like you are taking flight. And then you're closing. If you've ever taken a bar 3 class, we call this move drinking bird for some reason, but it really does remind me of taking flight. Everything lifts together. You've got this kind of like takeoff shape in your body. Just 4 more. Really try to isolate this work to the backside body. Release your neck, your shoulders. Awesome, 2 more. Last one. Good, stand tall, give your shoulders a roll. Okay, we're gonna do that same little leg sequence we did in warm up with your squat and your lunge. Arms are gonna do something a little different, and we're just gonna stay to one side. So start with your arms out in front of you. You're hugging a big beach ball, making this round shape. Hands are pretty much belly button height. You're gonna send your bum back into your sumo. We're gonna slide the left foot in towards the right, arms reach to the side, and then in towards your ribs. Left foot steps back, arms reach to the side, and then you hug that big beach ball, shoulders over top of your hips. Arms are gonna keep doing that little beach ball hug, and legs are gonna alternate between your squat and your lunge. Okay, so we are just moving to one side here. You're stepping out with the left foot into your squat, and then you're stepping back with the left foot into your lunge. So right leg's gonna get a little bit of work here. Yeah. If you wanna march, your left knee can come back to a march, and then step it back, and then march, and step to your sumo. Keep going. Good, these beach ball arms, honestly, some of my favorite ways to burn the shoulders and the chest. And then you get a little sneaky lat burn too when the elbows squeeze in. Can you find resistance? Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze right under your armpits. Over time, you'll feel that activation. All right, 2 more each direction. Keep your posture really long. Good. The next time you step the left foot back, just hold your lunge. So find your lunge, arms are hugging that beach ball. You can cross the weights if you want to hold them, and then pulse the legs for 10, 9, keep your elbows high. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stand tall, shake it out. Good, give your arms a little wiggle to release. And then just come into your sumo. We're gonna row fleshed out before you do your other side in those legs. So reach the arms down, and then squeeze the elbows at the top. Reach and squeeze, reach and squeeze, good. This is your chance to really let any tension go from your shoulders. And if you wanna switch it up here, we're gonna keep the elbows bent at the bottom and then stretch at the top. But this will be a little bit more shoulder, so just kind of choose if that's what you want in this moment. We've got a little bit more work coming. Last 4. 3, 2, and 1, stand tall. Awesome, shake it out. Come back to the top of your mat. We're gonna do that same sequence in the legs, but on the other side. Arms are gonna look a little different. Okay, so find your sumo squat, bum comes back. Arms are gonna pull in towards your side. Palms face the ceiling, elbows nice and high, so higher than your hips. You're gonna stand tall, serve the platter forward, palms still face the ceiling, and then step back, elbows come into your sides. All right, reach forward, step back, reach forward, step back. Good, I guess I should have said step to the side. You still got your sumo and your lunge. Okay, and then I'm gonna give you an option to switch up how you do the arms here. So you can do your serve the platter when you're at the bottom of your sumo. Elbows back as you stand tall, and then serve the platter at the bottom of your lunge. Do this option if your arms are feeling good and you want a little bit more work. This one's gonna be a little bit more challenging. Okay, so pick and choose based on how your body's feeling today. Maybe you're doing this video for the second time and you wanna do the other option. All right, things always feel different depending on so many factors in our lives before we work out, after we work out. So just make sure you're taking all that into account so that you don't injure yourself. You work out in a way that feels really good in your body in that moment, on that day. We gotta get used to being a little bit nicer to ourselves and making these conscious decisions in your workout to change it up based on how you're feeling is a really good way to show yourself some kindness and build those habits. Take them off your mat. All right, shoulders, chest, biceps should be feeling this by now. 2 more. The next time you're in your lunge, hold. Arms are gonna pull back, elbows behind you, pulse. Just 10. Good, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stand tall, shake it out. So good, have a sip of water. All right, we're coming down to your mat. Bring your weights with you and we'll put your booty band on your legs. Please come on down. Put your band right above your knees. If you don't have one, no problem, you don't need it. And then we'll just lie nice and flat. Okay, weights are definitely optional. I know we just did a bunch of upper bodies, so you can ditch them. If you want more work for your legs, bring your weights to your hips. Just let them kind of hang out on your hip crease. Feet nice and wide here, so think that same sumo shape we were just in standing. Turn the knees, the toes out, and then lift your hips. All right, so weights can be on your hip creases. They can be up towards the ceiling or no weights at all. We're gonna lower the hips to a hover, lift them to the top, press the thighs out into the band, and then release. So one lower, one press. Good. So feel that burn. Build pretty quickly on the outsides of your thighs. If this feels uncomfortable for your back or hips for any reason, I want you to come up to sumo squats and you can basically do the same thing. You lower, you press out, you release, you stand tall. You lower, press out, release, stand tall. Okay, so pick and choose. You can definitely stand up. Sometimes it just doesn't feel like you're jammed to lie down, no problem. Personally, I love lying down and working out. Why not? But the trick is when you're lying down and doing some mat work to keep your energy up. It's easy to kind of chill here, not work as hard. Can you use your big exhale to lift those hips, drive them up to the ceiling, press the thighs out, and then inhale to lower. Yes, so good. Quick check in with the core, ribs pull in and down. You can see a long line to your knees, okay? So don't let the hips come too high. A little different than your yoga bridge if you are someone who does yoga. A yoga bridge is a lot higher in the hips. Pilates or bar bridge, we keep the hips a little lower. Ooh, you are feeling that. I am right there with you. We have two more. The next time you lift, hold. Okay, we'll ditch that little press out for a second. Just pulse your hips to the ceiling. Okay, now's a really good time to check back in with your core. It's probably wanting ribs to splay out. Can you wrap them back in? And then press the back of your head into the mat, shoulders down away from your ears, making sure you're setting up the upper body for success so you can really focus on the burn and the bum, which I know is building, it's happening. There's no denying that. Woo. We have 10. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lower your hips. Oh my gosh, ooh, I'm feeling that. Okay, we're gonna rock up and down your spine, keep your band on, flip on over to hands and knees. Okay, so you don't need any weights for this, but keep your band on. Come down onto your right forearm. Left hand is in like a push-up position. We're gonna do some little kicks with your left knee out to the side. So everything stays stacked on the right side. Left knee just lifts and lowers. Okay, so a few ways to do this. You can definitely keep both arms down if that feels better. You can take your band off, or if you're doing this whole thing standing, just stand on up. Maybe you need the support of a wall or a chair or something, and then just lift that left knee. That's all we're doing. Okay, so get yourself set up. Make sure that right hip is staying right on top of your knee, whether you're standing or down on the mat. And then if your band gives you enough room and you have enough hip mobility, when you lift the knee out, I want you to do a little leg extension. Bend that knee back in and then close. If you end up spending a little bit more time under tension with that leg lifted. If you have one of these fabric bands like me, they don't have too much wiggle room. So you might not be able to lift your leg that high. That is totally fine. Keep going, whatever you can do. Check back in with the right hip. It's gonna wanna do this. It's really gonna wanna do this. Pull it back in, use your right oblique. Get out of your shoulders. Yes, good, much, much better. I know that you fixed that at home. Four more. Good, two more, no pulses, no holds. We're just gonna stand on up. Last one. So good, keep that band on, tuck your toes, lift your hips. Come into a sumo squat at the end of your mat. We're gonna do monster walk side to side before we do your fire hydrants on the other side. So just send your bum back, do your little walk side to side. We are burning out that side booty as much as we can today in one really long sequence. So if you need to take breaks because I'm not really gonna tell you to, that's up to you. I don't know how your body's feeling, but you do. Take those intentional breaks and then come back. All right, as you move here, what I see a lot, people lead with their ankle and then the knees start to cave in and it looks really sad and your knees will feel sad, your hips will feel sad. Lead with the thigh, push out. Keep that outward pressure even when you're taking that step in. Push out, keep it. Push out, keep it, yes. So there's no time where you're just like leading with your ankle bone and then pushing your knee out, okay? Lead with the thigh, keep going. Stick your bum back, chest nice and lifted, ribs in. Lots of things to think about. If you're ever like, Sydney, shush, just ignore me, move, enjoy your workout. One more time to the other end of your mat, so the side that you didn't start on. And then we'll pause, stand up, keep your band on, come all the way back down onto your left forearm this time, right hand plant, find those little fire hydrant kicks out to the side. I promise, your last thing with the band for the sequence. I know we've been doing it for what feels like forever, only been a few minutes. And then change what you need to on this side. You can come into this position I'm in, which is a little bit of an open tabletop position. You can definitely be on both hands or both elbows. And like I said earlier, you can also do this standing, just find your balance on your left leg. Right leg opens and closes. Yes, and if you have that space, that range, that ability with your booty band, lift the knee, kick the leg straight, bend it back in, and then close. Okay? That add-on depends on, honestly, so many factors. One mainly being your hip mobility. So if it doesn't feel like you can straighten your leg, don't worry about it. Keep going. Check in with that left hip. I know it's going to want to go to the left. Pull it back in. Right on top of your left knee. Left oblique. Working hard. Left shoulder. Pulling away from your ear. All right. Breathe big. If you don't have a mirror at home, and form is something that you're really working on, especially if you're newer to this type of workout and you don't get to do it in real life with an instructor there with you, maybe take a video of yourself and you can really see when the hips do want to come to the side, because I promise you everyone in my classes does this. It's not bad, it's just like what our body does. It tries to make it easier. I want you to try to focus on alignment. It's hard, that's okay. It should feel hard. You can do hard things. Just keep breathing. There. Again, no pulses, no holds in this one. We have four. Can you pull up through left side body like you're in a plank? Three. Two. And one. Release. So good. Okay, stand up. Take that band off. Just let it fall. All right. Make sure all your weights are off to the side. We're going to use them in a second, but first we're going to do some dissected low impact burpees. So come to the very top of your mat. Find a nice big sumo squat, hands to heart. You're gonna hit the floor with both hands. Step back into your plank. If you wanna do a push-up, be my guest. I don't though. You're gonna step back in, hands to heart, and then reach overhead. Switch whichever foot you're stepping back with each time, just so it's, everything is nice and even. And then this is kind of your blank canvas to add on to. If you wanna do high impact burpees, go for it, jump. Do a push-up, jump back to your plank. Just be really mindful when you're jumping back to plank that your core is strong enough to keep your hips at the height of your shoulders. All right, so don't do this. This happens a lot. Makes you want to die. Makes your back want to die. Keep your hips at the height of your shoulders and then land with the heels in your squat before you stand tall. Okay? If you want to add on and you're doing low impact, float the second leg and then step it back forward. You really got to make sure you're switching sides if you're doing that option. And if you are working on your push-ups, you can definitely bring your knees down every time you come out into your plank if you want to add on that push-up. Good. So many ways to do burpees. So many ways to make them work for your body, for your energy level that day. They don't have to be big and scary or awful or unenjoyable. All right, we have one more. Make it count. And then we have just a half rep. So the next time that you come down to your plank, hold. Find stillness. Find a plank you can hold and just stay. You've got 10 seconds. Change whatever you need. I want you to be able to hold this. Breathe. Again, just like warm up. After moving a bunch and then being still, stillness is harder. Use your breath. Stay present. You just have 5, 4, 3, 2, child's pose. Take a quick breather. Bum comes back. Ah, big inhale. Exhale, slowly roll up. So if you have that one heavier dumbbell, grab it now. If you don't, I'll show you other options. But we're gonna come sit onto our bums, bring that heavier weight with you. You're gonna hold onto either end of the dumbbell on the heads and just sit up really tall. We're gonna find a half roll back. So feet plant, sit on your sit bones and then lean back. You're gonna press the weight forward once and then overhead once. So I like doing this with one weight because it's really sturdy. And you can press into the weight like we would with a yoga block. Squeeze your hands into the weight. It'll work your chest like 8 million times more, scientifically, if you want. And if you don't have that one weight in each hand, that's a little bit lighter. It's a really great option. All right, make it work. If leaning back in this half rollback position just does not feel good for your hips or your low back, come onto your shins, reach the weight forward, and then up from here, okay? We've just got a little bit of arms and abs left to finish class. So keep your energy up. We're gonna spend most of it down on your mat. I want you to sit up really tall, really bright chest. Keep that breath big. Okay, only about 15 more seconds. Where's your breath? Can you sit up taller? Lots of questions you can ask yourself to stay present. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep that weight with you. Roll onto your back. Reach the weight overhead. Bring your knees to tabletop and just hold. Okay, we're gonna do a dead bug variation. So I still want you to think about squeezing that weight in with your palms, squeeze towards center. Weight comes overhead, right leg extends long. Do 3 pulses, 3, 2, 1. Come all the way back in, switch sides. 3, 2, 1, come all the way back in. All right, keep going like that. That is one option. Pulsing is definitely optional. If that feels bad for your low back, please, please don't do it. You can just extend and then come back in. And if you want feet planted, you can march here. So when the weight comes overhead, feet are planted. When the weight comes up, you march one leg and then you switch. Good, and then it'll look pretty much the same if you've got one weight in each hand. Keep moving and whatever option feels good and works with the props you have at home. Okay, so I like to teach with a neutral spine. You'll probably hear a lot of instructors say to smush your low back into the mat and imprint your spine. For me, that feels honestly awful in my low back. So I like to teach a neutral spine. So when we're doing this work on our back, a neutral spine means you could pretty much put one finger right between your mid back and the mat. So instead of having to smush that area into the ground, you have a neutral spine, and your neutral spine is how you sit, it's how you stand, it's how you are all day. So it's really nice for me at least, and I think for a lot of my clients, to build strength in that neutral spine because that's how we're existing in the rest of our lives, right? So as you move your limbs away from center, really try to keep that neutral spine by containing through the front side of your core and not letting your pelvic bone do any sort of tilting or tucking. All right, when you hear people talking about deep core exercises, this is one of them. We get to do a lot of work here without having to add on a crunch. And staying with your breath is really, really important. Keep checking in with that neutral spine. You've got a little space between your back and the mat. It's not getting bigger or smaller, no matter where your limbs are in this movement. You have one more each side. Good. Finish off on the left. Stay on your back. Bring the weight above your head. Be careful if your ponytail is big like mine. Oh, ripped a few hair outs, that's okay. Okay, you're gonna bring the weight behind your head. We're gonna do some reverse crunches. If you have light weights, this won't really work with the weight. You can ditch it, arms come down beside you. Or if you're near a couch or your bed, bring your hands underneath the bottom of your bed or couch. Legs are gonna come up towards the ceiling, nice and straight, squeeze them together. Super important to squeeze them together. You're gonna inhale, lower the legs just to a 45. Exhale, lift them back up, and then do a reverse crunch. You're gonna lift your hips to the ceiling, drop them back down really gently, do that lower. And your lift. Okay, so a few options. That's one. Knees can stay bent. This is two. If your knees are bent, you can probably tap your toes fully to the floor. That's fine. And if moving both legs together bothers your hip flexors or your low back, do one leg straight, one knee into chest, and then switch. I honestly sometimes feel this version more. So feel free to kind of play around with your options. Now, I want you to imagine you've got a friend, we used to do this in dance, a friend would stand beside your head and then put their hands like here, so your legs couldn't do this big swing. If you swinged, you would have kicked them. So try to keep your feet from coming above your eye line, because as soon as they do, you're kind of coming up into a shoulder stand. I want you to think about feet going straight up towards the ceiling. That way you're really using your lower abs. That fire in your belly should be burning. We have four more. Keep your form really strong till the end. Three. Two. And one. Hug your knees into your chest. Really good work. Rock side to side, nice and gently. All right, ditch your weight. Leave it there again. Careful if your hair got stuck in it. And then rock up and down. I have left up here on the mat before. Okay, you're gonna come into a reverse tabletop. So feet and hands plant, you're sitting on your bum, and then you just lift your hips up. Should feel like a nice stretch for the fronts of the shoulders after that work we just did. Hips are gonna lower, and then you're gonna march. Lift your right knee up, lower everything down. Don't let your bum actually touch the floor. Switch sides, and just keep going. Inhale, lower, exhale, lift. Inhale, lower, exhale, lift. If this feels good, you feel balanced here, I want you to reach for your opposite toes. So bum comes low, when my right leg lifts, my left hand is gonna tap for it, come back down, and then switch. All right, if you're doing this option, your hips might not come as high, but still think about lifting them up off the floor. Okay, if that is just like not happening, shoulders don't love it, whatever. Come back onto your elbows, do your alternating marches here. From your elbows, if you want, you can reach. So as always, find that option that works. That core burn should be burning. See if you can find a little bit more of an oblique twist here, especially if you're reaching for your feet. Last four, three, two, and one. Awesome, quick fold over. Circle out your wrist. We're pretty much gonna do that, but flipped over on hands and knees facing your mat. So just flip on over. All right, so a few options here. I'm gonna show you your full option in your bare first. So come onto hands and knees, tuck your toes. You're gonna lift your knees and then do opposite hand to opposite toe. So literally the same thing we just did on our back, but you're down. Try to keep your hips low this time. Okay, so that's one option. Your other option is to reach for opposite thigh, touch opposite thigh. And then your other option, if bare just isn't in the cards for you, which is no problem, you're gonna come to a full plank. You're gonna lift your hips up to a down dog, cross one hand towards your opposite ankle, come back to your plank, and then switch. All right, so no option is better or worse, harder or easier. There is just one option that feels the best for you today. So find that one, move there. Again, working the obliques as you find that little twist, just to tap towards either your thigh or your foot or your ankle. Whatever you're doing, that other shoulder has to really stabilize to support the rest of your weight. So push that shoulder away from the ears and just keep moving really big. I honestly love this option. It just feels really nice. Oh yeah, but bare to toe tap is the hardest for me. You have 10 more seconds here. Final four, three, two, and one. Knees down, hips back. Take a child's pose, take a big breath in. Exhale, slowly roll up. All right, we just have one final exercise and then we'll do a quick stretch. Okay, so grab your booty band. You're gonna bring it around your feet. Now, I have one of those really tight ones, so I don't get much movement on this one, but if you have a loose one, this one's really fun. So you're gonna do your V-sit basically with your band. It helps you quite a bit. So bring your feet up, find your V-sit, hold onto your band. It's around the bottoms of your feet, right around the middle. And then on an inhale, you're gonna press your feet out, lean back. On an exhale, you're gonna come back up. Inhale, press. Exhale, lift. Okay, so if you have a super loose band, you definitely can come a little bit lower than I am. Like, I feel like I'm gonna break my band. And then you can come back in. If you are someone that knows you can do this without the help of the band, awesome. Ditch it, find your boat pose. Arms just reach forward, palms lift, and then you're gonna lower, and then you're gonna lift. Okay, but if this is something that you're working towards, having the band helps a lot, and it should help you keep that tension out of your hip flexor. Okay, either way, squeeze those inner thighs, belly button to spine, chest nice and bright. This is your last, about 15 seconds of work. Enjoy it. And then we're gonna stretch. Okay, keep breathing. This is your final 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Sit up tall. Knees fall to the side, fold forward. Amazing work. Shake out the head. Take a big inhale. Sit on up. Good. Get rid of your props. Plant your hands behind you. Find a gentle windshield wiper, knees side to side. Good. Okay, flip on over. We're going to come into a few cat-cows. So hands and knees again. Just drop the belly, lift the gaze. Inhale. Stretch out your core. Exhale, round your spine. Drop your head. One more. And then drop your head. All right. Circle your right arm one time. Reach it forward, up and back. And then circle it halfway up to the ceiling. And then twist. Bring your right ear, right shoulder down. Really just stretching in between the shoulder blades, relaxing through your neck. Take a breath in, and a breath out. We're gonna do that one more time, but send your right leg straight to the side. Same arm, right arm reaches up, and then straight underneath. You should feel a pretty intense inner thigh stretch here. Open up through that hip. One breath in, and out. Awesome, just switch sides. Left arm does one full circle, and then one half circle, and then twist underneath. Good, hold here for a breath. Maybe close your eyes. Unwind. And then same thing, left foot comes all the way out to the side. And then left arm comes back to the ceiling. Rotate underneath. Right ear comes down. You can really get a big stretch on the inner thigh. Sometimes you don't feel it, but if the inner thigh is sore, oh my God, this is heaven. Take one breath. Unwind. Back through center. Come onto both shins. Just bring your hands behind you. Interlace your fingers. Look up. Inhale. Exhale, hands to knees, round your spine.
Spread out between the shoulder blades, take a breath in.
Exhale, find a forward fold, tuck your toes, lift your hips.
Shake everything out here, take an inhale. Exhale, slowly roll up, head comes up last. Good.
Take one last breath. I want you to scoop up all that good energy you just created in your body. Exhale, hands through heart center. Amazing work. Thank you so much for joining me as always. Please leave a comment in the comment section if you took class, what you thought of it, any other classes you want. And of course, subscribe so I can keep making these classes for you. See you next time.